As was customary for Porfirio, he was truly enjoying the peaceful Monday afternoon, madereándose en el porch. He continued looking up the street for signs of his children to get home from their first day of la escuela while sipping on his ice-cold Schlitz beer. This year marked the first time the Barcelonas had at least one chavalo in each grade, beginning with Pampilo in first and ending with Porfirio Jr. in 12th. The feat was the first ever accomplishment in the Taft Independent School District by any familia, and barring any unforeseen circumstances, it would be repeated at least two more times by the Barcelonas since they still had Ponce and Panchito waiting in the wings. As he turned and looked up the street for what appeared to be the 100th time, Porfirio noticed the first sign of chavalitos making their way to their cantos, and he raised himself up and adjusted his sitting position so he could get a better view of the shadowy figures approaching from a distance. Porfirio's sudden change in posture startled Solovino, the Barcelona family dog, who was lying down asleep on the corner of the porch not too far to the left of Porfirio. The old lazy dog sensed something or someone had caught his master's attention, and he raised his head momentarily to see what was going on. Porfirio noticed that Solovino had been startled, so he looked back at the dog and told him to go back to sleep. The dog was a dark brown, medium-sized, unattractive mutt and had the characteristics of a Labrador retriever, mixed in with traces of some type of hound. Watching Solovino show some signs of life brought Porfirio some memories of when the dog was still a pup, had lots of energy and pep, and chased after anything and everything that moved. He recalled how in his younger days, Solovino would often come home with other people's clothes that he had snagged from their clothesline, or with somebody's shoe which had probably been left on someone's porch. Porfirio even recalled the day he walked out into the front porch of the house and found the ill-behaved animal with one of Don Crispin Arredondo's white rabbits locked in the tight grip of his jaw. Don Crispin was an elderly man who lived with his wife Herminia across the street from the Barcelonas, and had several cages and coops filled with rabbits, hens, roosters, and turkeys in his backyard. Somehow Solovino managed to get a hold of one of their bunnies and was violently shaking the fluffy creature up and down and from side to side as blood, spit, and fur flew everywhere. As soon as Porfirio saw what Solovino was doing to the defenseless creature, he rushed into the house, grabbed the broom, and came out and started hitting Solovino to force him to let go of the bloody rabbit. By the time the dog released the furry animal, was already dead, and Porfirio, not wanting Don Crispin to find out what happened, quickly grabbed the lifeless creature and took it inside. He placed the dead bunny in the kitchen sink on one of its sides and started washing all the blood and dog spit off of it. He then flipped the rabbit over and washed the other side. When he finished doing this, he grabbed some towels and began drying it off. Next, he took the animal into the living room and placed it in front of a fan so the warm air could dry it off even more. Finally, he took one of the horse's hairbrushes and began to gently groom the bunny's fur until he got the creature to almost look alive again. After he finished doing all this, Porfirio carefully placed the bunny inside a plastic bag and went back outside and sat on the porch. As soon as he saw Don Crispin go inside the house, Porfirio sneaked across the street into his neighbor's backyard. He quietly pulled the dead animal out of the plastic bag and placed it in one of the cages, making it appear as if the animal was asleep. Porfirio then quickly and quietly snuck back to his house and sat outside on the porch as he waited to see what would happen next. Around 30 minutes after Porfirio had replaced the rabbit, he saw Don Crispin's wife Herminia come outside with a bucket of seeds to feed the hens and roosters. Porfirio watched curiously as Herminia passed the rabbit cage and suddenly began screaming hysterically and yelling for her husband to come outside. Porfirio watched as Herminia ran frantically around the rabbit cage, jumping up and down like a chicken with its head chopped off. He waited for Don Crispin to exit the house and then rushed across the street, pretending not to know what was going on. "Is Herminia okay?" asked Porfirio. "She's in shock," said Don Crispin. "Why? What happens?" asked Porfirio, haciéndose el pendejito. "Well, it's just that yesterday her favorite bunny, Fluffy, died, and we buried it in the backyard. But now, for some mysterious reason, the damn thing is back in its cage again." "Oh," said Porfirio, trying hard not to laugh. "That's very strange." "It sure is," said Don Crispin, as he grabbed the dead animal and went and buried it in the ground one more time.